August 2017, Cassini captured 6 images of Enceladus, one of the most intriguing moons in the solar system.
Enceladus is a relatively small moon of Saturn that's pretty easy to ignore, but once you pay attention to it, hosts a lot of surprises.
We've known something was unusual about this icy world ever since the Voyager mission took photographs in 1980.
We thought that Enceladus would be frozen solid, and yet we knew from Voyager data the surface of Enceladus was bright white.
And we could see on the surface that vast tracts of it were smooth, at least at the resolution that we had with Voyager. And that immediately says that there's been internal activity, because that's really on an airless moon, that's the only process that could erase craters.
Scientists suspected something was actively resurfacing Enceladus, filling in its craters to make it smooth and bright. Then, Cassini sent back pictures of Enceladus backlit, and all was revealed.
We saw these icy jets shooting out from Enceladus, and everyone was so amazed that a moon so tiny and assumed to be a frozen solid ice cube could be so active.
Jets of almost luminous material spraying out of geysers.
When I first saw a picture of a geyser on Enceladus, I mean, I was floored. That's amazing. I had no idea that that was even possible.
The Cassini discovery of geysers on Enceladus was a game changer. All of a sudden, here's water jetting out. It was like too good to be true.
Cassini revealed the geysers are blasting out liquid water. Enceladus is not a solid ball of ice.
As we got more data from Cassini, we found that Enceladus had a wobble that was too large for a body that was frozen solid all the way through, and that told us that a liquid water ocean circled a rocky core.
Enceladus has liquid water under its surface, and it may very well be an ocean, basically covering the inside of that moon. But where's the heat coming from?
When planets and moons form, their cores are incredibly hot. But over time, they cool down. The smaller the planet, the faster it cools. A tiny world like Enceladus, over 1 billion miles from the sun, should have frozen solid by now.
That's what we expected. If things are smaller, then they would be roughly dead and they'd be covered by craters. But Enceladus shows us that that's not the case at all.
How could a tiny moon, so far from the sun, have enough warmth for liquid water? One idea is tidal heating.
If you've ever played racquetball, you know as you play the game, the ball heats up. And this is because as the ball hits the racket or the wall, it's getting squished and then it relaxes.
Saturn's gravity squishes and relaxes Enceladus as it orbits the planet, heating it like a racquetball. But this alone wouldn't generate enough heat to stop Enceladus's water from freezing. Something else must be going on in the core.
What if the core of Enceladus is actually kind of gravelly? Instead of it just being solid, it's actually made of rocks and pebbles and gravel all put together. Then what happens is, as the tides are stretching and squeezing it, those rocks are rubbing together, and that actually generates even more energy.
2017. A computer model based on Cassini data revealed this tidal friction generates more energy than America's biggest power station. Water heated to 194 degrees Fahrenheit rises to the surface. It sprays through cracks in the moon's south pole, creating misty plumes.
As we flew 7 times through and tasted and sampled the gas and the particles, we found salty particles, that the ocean was salty, very much like the Earth's ocean. We found hydrocarbons, methane, carbon dioxide, ammonia. We found the key ingredients for life coming out of the jets of Enceladus. So remarkable.
In 2018, scientists reanalyzed the Enceladus data and found something even more remarkable. Complex organic molecules.
What they found were larger organic compounds than initially thought there. At first, it was just dust and water and some basic organics. Now they're seeing more complex stuff coming up from Enceladus' interior. And that asks the question, what else is down there?
On Earth, we find life huddled around hot vents on the seabed. Could the same be true in the oceans of Enceladus? Could these complex organic molecules be signs of life?
My favorite name for them is goo. They're gooey things. And think of life as a collection of gooey-like molecules. Now, that doesn't mean that all gooey molecules are biological, but certainly biology makes use of these complex organic molecules.
Deep in Enceladus's oceans, heat from hydrothermal vents drives chemical reactions. Combining simple molecules like methane and hydrogen into longer, complex organic molecules. Complex molecules that could serve as the precursors to life.
What's amazing is the chemistry of that ocean. Everything needed for life is there.
The eternal question is there life in the universe? And Enceladus is a great place to try and answer that question.
And Cassini revealed secrets of another moon of Saturn with amazing chemistry. A giant moon with Earth-like features, rivers, lakes, and dunes. Titan.